and setting the theme for this conference and also for these kind words of welcome. Ladies and gentlemen, we have on the dais with us Mr. K.R. Sanjeev, who is the Chief Technology Officer and Senior Vice President of Wipro's Global IT Business. He leads the company's technology vision and strategy. Mr. Sanjeev joined Wipro in 1989 and served as the Global Head of Analytics and Information Management for several years, carrying a P&L responsibility before taking on the role of CTO. Mr. Sanjeev holds a bachelor's degree from the Birla Institute of Technology and Science, BITS Pilani, India. And I have the proud privilege in inviting Mr. K.R. Sanjeev for the keynote address. Please put your hands together to welcome him.
Good morning. And it's a real privilege and pleasure to be part of this conference on such a vital topic, especially from the technology industry of which I'm a part of for almost 3 decades now. All of you must be witnessing a lot of these impact or technologies which are getting disrupted or which are creating disruptions in the current industrial scenario, even social scenario for that matter. There are these big technologies which not only promise to disrupt and improve the performance and efficiencies to a level which is unheard of, but they pretty much redefine a lot of the way of life which we live in. It's not that these innovations or inventions are new to the industry. You know, we had the 80s where we had the PC revolution. We had the 90s where we had the internet coming and creating a big change. We had the 2000s, which was the mobile, you know, revolutions in many parts of the world. But this one, this decade, over the last 4 or 5 years, is pretty different. It's drastically different. It's not just one technology. It's not just one mammoth disruptive technology playing out. It's a plethora of them. You have AI, cognitive, which you heard Dr. Datta refer in the earlier session, but then you also have a huge list. You have IoT, smart devices, you have robotics, you have 3D printing, you have augmented reality, virtual reality, blockchain, right? It's almost as if each of these by themselves, you know, are capable of complete disruption. They are the 800-pound gorillas, but then you have a situation where you just not have one 800-pound gorilla, but a whole truckload of them coming, barreling down at you at a huge pace, right? And that's different. That's completely different. You look at AI, you know, the promise of AI, or the way it is being rolled out. You know, it has been simmering for a long time till it reached its inflection point. But when it took off, it has really taken off. It is not only disrupt, it's not only eliminating or completely automating some of the low-end jobs, right, but even the high-end jobs, you know, the medical diagnosis, the audit function, the financial trading, or even from a legal processing, right, the amount of cognition that it brings in creates a totally new different dimensions of productivity. Right, cycle times, accuracies. So it's a huge, powerful innovation that's happening around that. You look at 3D printing, it will pretty much redefine the value chain distribution of manufacturing, the manufacturing world globally. Blockchain, right? If you look at some of the processes, like international remittances, at 1/10 the cost, that's a promise it has, that's a capability that it has. Or its concept of distributed ledgers that can completely make redundant some of the billion-dollar industries and expenses that organizations have, reconciliations, right? They don't need to exist. A single ledger, proof of truth, right? Absolute truth in the entries. Why do you need to reconcile? And that's a billion-dollar industry out of the window. Similarly, the list is long. I won't get into details. But the key is all these are happening on the back of a lot of inventions and innovations that is happening across the world. You look at the IPOs, I mean, there is a reflection of this, proof points of this across. You look at the startups which are getting registered in this space, hundreds, thousands. In the Valley itself, we had about 300 startups in the AI space in the last couple of years. The investments in blockchain, IPOs, ICOs, the more exciting form of IPOs, right? Excess of $1 billion in the last 1.5 years in the blockchain industry. Obviously, these are all innovations which are pumping. From a Wipro itself, the last couple of years, we have filed 500 patents each year. And we'll be doing pretty much the same this year. And that's a fourfold, fivefold increase than what we used to do 4 years back, 5 years back. Right? So the pace, the story has just begun. It is just the tip of the iceberg that we are seeing right now. The real game is yet to be played out, and the amount of inventions and innovations that will come out is going to be phenomenal. Right? And in these inventions and innovations, we need the system, we need all the ecosystems that support it as we move forward. But then, in this reimagined world, right, we have to reimagine all the processes. There are issues and complexities which we need to address to be relevant for any supporting ecosystem to propel the original spirit of the main cause, innovation out here. Right? If you look at it, and I'll mention some of them which I've seen and observed, you know, I'm not from the law industry, but then I've been consumer and an active participant. You know, the first thing that comes to mind is the speed, is the aspect of speed. The speed of innovation is phenomenal. It's almost like the innovation is on wheels run by, it's on steroids, the speed at which is happening. How many of you would have heard of blockchain 2 years back? I doubt if any. Even I hadn't heard. We would have heard of Bitcoin, but not of blockchain. You look at the awareness around blockchain today, you know, right from the colleges to the industry, to the administrators, right, to political parties, everybody is deeply aware and can spend 5 minutes talking on how they will consume blockchain, right? From concept, from a virtually unknown entity to a completely, universally across industries, across geographies, across various sections, in 2 years, and if it sustains the pace, it will pretty much become completely in production in the next couple of years. And believe me, these are changes that are not just incrementally giving you 40%, 50% kind of unimaginable performance improvement. They completely disrupt. If blocking chains, you can do banking without a bank, that's reimagining an institution or a society where certain institutions were very core to us for centuries, right? The autonomous car, the car industry didn't move an inch for 90 years and suddenly it's taken off, literally taken off, right? So these are big changes, right? The speed at which they are happening is fast. At Wipro, when I took over as CTO, we were thinking how to create new user experiences using holographic technologies. This was 3 years back. And even as we were discussing, we had Mr. Modi use it in his campaign, right? So you are discussing the roadmap and you have production happening. In our industry, in the ICT industry, the cycle from concept to pilot to production to commoditization, we believe is a 4 to 5 year cycle, right? And it's important that, you know, IPs and patent rights and the whole process of patenting and getting the benefits of patenting fits into that cycle. Today, I think on an average, we take 3 to 4 years to get a patent right. And the life is 20 years. 20 years is legacy, right? The second is an aspect of cost, and I think there was a reference to how innovations will happen across, and it's true. A lot of IT innovations will happen in the garages by the startups, not by the big billion-dollar companies alone, right? And it happens, it's unlike, let's say, a drug industry or a pharma industry where you have a new disease and a new medicine that will come out in 1 year, 1.5 years, and have a life of 10 years. This is by the quarter, this moves by the quarter. But then the volumes are large. It is large number of inventions mushrooming in small periods of time. The aggregate value of this, the aggregate impact of this is as big as the large ones. How do you address that aspect when innovations happening in garage can be protected and can be encouraged? The cost, the current costs need to be, we need to rethink. It's pretty expensive to file a patent. Not just the patent expenses, but the additional expenses of lawyers and, you know, the whole legal process involved. I don't think an innovator sitting in a garage can afford it, can sustain it. Nor can many of these startups which have an idea. They'll find it very, very taxing to pursue this, and I'm not sure how much of encouragement this ecosystem will give in this current cost point. So we need to look at that. And third and the last one, you know, it's slightly more long term, but then it's equally true, it will play out, is the more complexities of ownership, right? Who owns an IP? If an AI engine creates a picture, an art, and these are all happening these days, forget the more intricate one. If I, as an inventor, use an AI algorithm made by a third party and create an invention, who owns it? Right? Is it the person who created the IP, whose asset I used? Is it me who used the tool? Right? It's similar to your insurance complexity or any of the legislative complexities in an autonomous car. A car creates an accident. Whom do you catch? The owner of the car, the manufacturer, or the company which made the software somewhere else in the world? Right. So the ownership issues are going to get much more complex. It will not be a very straightforward straitjacket, right? This person and this IP. How do we get ready for it? I think there are a long list, I'm sure, in the workshops and conferences you'll bring out. And from an industry perspective, I certainly look forward to the entire IPR ecosystem that emerges, that tunes itself to really promote the innovations which are going to happen. Even from a nation perspective, from an India perspective, this is an opportunity where, you know, our innovators, our startups have the ability to create the next billion-dollar idea, and we would definitely like the patent laws from the country to be robust and encouraging and protective. Look forward to a lot of innovations coming from the IPR team itself, and